Welcome back to this course on Project 2013 Advanced. In this section we're going to look at budget costs, and in fact including in that I'm going to look at budgeting in general in Project 2013. I hope it's something you've come across before, but I do find it's one area of 2013 where people do get quite confused about what it means and what the relationship is between a budget and a baseline and actuals and so on. And during this and the next few sections I hope to explain all that more fully to you and to add a lot of details to things you may have used before. Now the first thing to understand is that a budget has nothing to do with tracking actual costs, even scheduled costs or scheduled assignments or scheduled use of resources and so on. A budget is purely a set of numbers that is, if you like, your best guess. It may be your budget in the sense of being a limit either to the amount of money you have or the amount of resources you can use, but basically it's usually there because you've been required either at the start of a project or even before a project begins to come up with a budget for the project. Now one thing you can do in Project 2013 is to set up a budget with various components very easily, and then you can track your progress against that budget along with your progress against things like your baseline. So first of all, let's set up a budget for this pretty straightforward project. Now I must admit to an element of cheating here, because normally if I were required to do a budget for a project it would be even before I'd done this level of detailed planning. Even here, although I've got a lot more breakdown of these tasks and more investigation of resources and so on to go into, I've already got a pretty good idea of what this project's going to cost. So I want you to sort of cast your mind back a few months before I had even this Gantt chart, and my boss has said to me, we're thinking of putting together a new website and we're going to be able to do this on it and this on it and this on it, and give me a long list of what we might be able to do, and we want it to work like this, and we want it to be able to take this many visitors and do this amount of business online on it and so on. And then he might say to me, can you give me some idea, Toby, of what that's going to cost? Come up with a budget for the whole project. So I know that in order to do this we're going to need to get some specialist help from outside. We've got a web development company and we've got some business consultants who can help us with these jobs. We're going to do a certain amount of the work in-house. We're going to be able to do quite a lot of the testing. We'll even be able to do some of the development work, but mainly we'll be working on requirements and elements of design. So I go away, I look at the last website development project we did, I look at how much more complex this one is, but on the other hand how much more we've learnt, and I come up with some figures and say, well, based on past experience and based on what I think's involved here, I think we're going to need about 900 hours of our own time in-house work. So that's roughly 100 days, a bit over 100 days of work for internal resources, and I'd say probably about the same amount of time from external resources, say about 900 hours of external resources, consultants, web developers and so on. I'll also look at the likely costs. Now let's assume that we've got all the computer equipment we need to do the development. We may need to buy the odd bit here and there, we may need a little bit more hardware to do some testing on, but apart from that we've got very little in the way of additional costs. Graphical resources and branding work, for example, is being done either by our own people or by agencies. So from a point of view of direct material use, we're talking about a pretty small amount. I mentioned earlier in the course about the tendering process and paying for the materials to be prepared on that. But let's suppose that I think, well, let's allow $5,000. Let's say that just for budget costs, apart from resources of course, let's allow another $5,000. And that's the figure I'm going to put into my budget. So first of all, let me set up my budget work resources. I go to the resource sheet and on there I'm going to add a resource. I'm going to add what I'm going to call internal resource, and defaults to a type of work. I'm going to call that internal and then open that up and mark it as a budget resource. Click on OK and then add So that's two budget work resources to begin with. Now I'm going to add a third resource. I'm going to call this budget cost. It's really unclear at this stage what I'm including in that, and of course it is unclear. I've come up with a figure there really based on a couple of guesses and a little bit of conservative estimation. Very often budget costs will be based on previous experience with similar projects, but I'm going to say budget cost. I'm going to change the type of that to cost, and I'm going to call that just budget, and then I'm going to open that up and make that budget as well. Click on OK. So there are my three budget resources set up. Now these are budget resources, so they cannot be allocated to individual tasks within my project. I have to assign them to the project summary task. So I go to the Gantt chart and click on the Format tab to locate the checkbox where I can enable the project summary task. Once the project summary task is enabled, right click on that, click on Assign Resources, and I'm now going to assign those three budget resources. Now at the point of assigning budget resources, you cannot enter the number of units. You can only assign the resource to the project summary task. So I'm going to select budget cost and external resource and internal resource and click on assign. All three of those are now assigned. You can see the tick there, but obviously no figures at all. Close. And now what I need to do is to actually put the amounts in. Now in order to put the amounts in, I need a different view, and I need to go to either task usage or resource usage view, and I'm going to go to task usage view. Now you can start to see here the reason for needing this view, because when you go into task usage view, for each task in the project you have listed underneath it the resources, and in the case of the project summary task they are the three resources: internal resource, external resource and budget cost. Now I'm just going to move this dividing line over here, because what I need to do now is to show two fields that aren't normally shown. So in here I'm going to insert column. The column I'm going to insert is budget cost, which is there, and then here I'm going to insert another column, which is budget work. And these are the columns that I use to enter the figures that I've already estimated. So in internal resource I put my 900 hours in there, so I just type 900. In external resource I put 900, and in budget cost I put 5000. And now you can see against the project summary task my budget figures. My budget for this project is $5,000 of cost and 1800 hours of work. Now I need to explain one small thing here, and that's the number you can see here, 1710.4 hours. I mentioned earlier on that generally speaking I'd be doing this budgeting much earlier on in the life of a project, before I'd drawn out a Gantt chart with any level of detail in it. And having drawn that Gantt chart out and estimated the amount of work needed to complete this project, as you can see I've already effectively got a work figure. But this work figure, which is just below my budget work figure, this work figure is actually the scheduled amount of work. So that's my work scheduled figure. That's my budget work figure. So far I haven't got a baseline work figure, so I haven't taken my schedule and said that's the one I'm working to, that's my baseline, and I haven't got any actual work figures at all yet. So the four sets of figures, budget, baseline, scheduled and actual, are starting to take shape, and later on in the course when we get to the tracking and entering of actuals and so on, we'll be able to do a more complete comparison. At the moment we've just set up the budget. Okay, so that's the basics of my project budget. Now I'm going to come back to that a little bit later on when we come to reviewing progress. That's it for this section. I'll see you in the next one.